Hey guys, it's Emily from Heartmybody Fitness. Today I want to share with you on a topic that is so near and dear to my heart, how to stop hating food. Now you might be thinking, Emily, that's insane because I love food and I do too. That's not what I mean. You don't actually like hate food. We love food. But really what I'm saying is how to stop having a negative or hateful relationship with food and how to stop hating yourself in that relationship. If you think there's someone out there who would benefit from a conversation like this, please share this video out with them and be sure to subscribe to my channel because I'm putting out new videos every Monday. This type of topic is one that we don't talk about enough. And as women, there's so much self-hatred and body image issues and we just frankly don't talk about this enough for us to have a really healthy relationship with ourselves, with our food, and with our bodies. Now, if you've seen any of the previous videos that I've posted or the stuff that I share on social media, then you probably have seen a lot of workouts, a lot of really yummy looking food, at least in my opinion. And it might look like, well, that's a healthy situation right there. And it is now. But to give you a little context, it hasn't always been that way. I had an eating disorder as a teenager and I set very stringent limits around what I could eat, what I couldn't eat, what was good food, what was bad food. And I remember hating myself for a lot of reasons, but you know, I would hate myself if I saw all my friends eating foods that I thought were bad foods. Then I would hate myself for not partaking in that, not engaging with my friends, not cutting myself some slack. But then I'd also hate myself if I did eat those foods and then feel terrible about it afterwards. So basically there's hatred all around. Whether you do or you don't, you still end up feeling terrible about yourself. And it wasn't just that I had disordered eating, it was that I had extremely disordered thinking. And I see that others have a negative relationship with food all the time, especially as women. You'll hear things like, you know, I cheated on my diet this week, I was really bad with my food, or I ate way too much last night, I need to stop being such a pig, or things like, and I know I've done this before, watching what other people are eating to see what's acceptable and how much is acceptable for you to be eating, feeling like crap if you ate more than you had planned, or telling yourself that you'll be better next time, and then when next time comes, you're still bad, and so then you're just in this negative cycle and downward spiral of feeling terrible about yourself. I'm so happy to share with you guys that 10 years after the height of my eating disorder, I feel fantastic. I feel like I've got more energy than ever. I feel happier with my body than ever. And food isn't taking up all my mental space. That negativity that I felt for so long is completely gone. There's no more guilt. It's just freedom to be and to enjoy all the cool things about life. I was recently challenged to think about how I overcame this negative relationship with food, and it was actually really hard because now it feels so natural. It's not even something that I have to try at or really think about, but it wasn't always like that, and so it really got me thinking about what were the strategies that I took? What was the mindset shift that I had to make in order to get to this place? And that's what I want to share with you guys today. So if you're feeling like your relationship with food could be happier, healthier, then this video is for you, and these are my tips for creating a healthy relationship with food. Tip number one is to think about food as fuel. If food is fuel, then food is inherently good. Food fuels us to be able to do the things that we love in life. We cannot live without it, so we shouldn't hate it. Not all fuel is created equal though. Some fuels will serve our body better than others. For instance, a chicken breast and some sweet potato and vegetables, which is what I had for lunch, will fuel me much better throughout my day and leave me feeling better than, say, a donut. If we start prioritizing foods that are going to fuel us well, then we're naturally going to be drawn to foods that have more health benefits. Tip two is that no foods are off limits. I can eat whatever I want, whenever I want. I've got the freedom to make that choice for myself. If we start putting restrictions, like this is food that I can eat, this is food that I can't eat, then we're setting ourselves up to either succeed or to fail, and ultimately to feel bad about ourselves if we fail. So my mindset is that I get to eat whatever I want and I'm not gonna feel bad about it. If I want pizza, I'm gonna have that pizza, I'm gonna thoroughly enjoy it, and I'm gonna leave that experience completely guilt-free. This is a complete 180 from me 10 years ago when even the slightest hiccup in what I was supposed to eat would make me feel awful about myself for days. That said, I can eat whatever I want, but then the question becomes, what do I choose to eat? What do I want to eat? This relates back to tip number one, because most of the time, I'm gonna wanna choose foods that will serve me both physically and mentally. Unprocessed foods, vegetables, fruits, lean sources of protein, nuts, whole grains. And if I choose to sometimes stray from that, then that's okay. I'm gonna enjoy it. I'm gonna do it occasionally, but I'm not gonna feel bad about it. My third and final tip is to only associate neutral or positive words with our food, but nothing with a negative connotation. I want you to think about how you're thinking about food. Do you ever notice if you say, whether it's out loud or in your head, something negative about yourself in relationship to your food, or something negative about the food itself? Because here's the thing, if we associate negative words, thoughts to our food, then food becomes something bad. And if I'm eating something bad, then I'm probably gonna feel bad about it. So let me give you my favorite example, cheat foods. If you've used this before, you're still an awesome person. I hate that term, I hate it. I've been cheated on. Cheating sucks. Cheating is not something that I want to do. So why would I associate the word cheating with my food? I wouldn't. I don't want it. It's too negative. So when other people say cheat foods, I say treat foods. And I know others do this, and I love this movement toward thinking about those foods that you kind of are indulging in as treats, not something you're doing bad, not something you're cheating with. And I'm gonna enjoy every single second of that treat food, but since it is a treat, I'm not gonna eat it all the time. Other examples are like bad foods or unhealthy foods. Sure, there are lots of foods out there that taste great, but don't serve your body very well. But if I'm thinking of foods from a perspective of good versus bad, I'm always gonna feel bad about myself if I go for the bad food, right? Again, nothing is off limits. It's all fair game. My solution is to think about foods in terms of how they serve me, and that's both mentally and physically. I'll definitely share more on this strategy, but if a food serves me both mentally and physically, I'm all about it. Like, that's gonna be primarily what I'm eating. If a food serves me mentally but not physically, like a food that tastes really good or has a positive memory associated with it, then I'm gonna sometimes eat it, but maybe not all the time, right? That's more of the treat foods. If a food doesn't serve me mentally and only serves me physically, like I know that it's really good for me, but I hate the way it tastes, then again, I'm gonna probably be eating it, but not as often as I would if it did both. And then if a food doesn't serve me mentally and doesn't serve me physically, I'm not eating it, like, ever, unless I was on like a deserted island. So those are my three tips on how to stop hating food. Tip number one is to start thinking about food as fuel. Tip number two is that no foods are off limits. Tip number three is to only associate neutral or positive terms with food, never negative terms. My final note is that this is not easy. It is hard to change our mindset that we've developed over our entire life around food. So it might take months, even years in my case, to change this, but it is so worth it. So if you start to notice yourself falling back into old habits, stop yourself. Maybe you've got to write this stuff down. Maybe you've got to repeat it in your head multiple times, whatever strategy is going to work for you. But I do know that this has worked tremendously for me. It's given me the ability to feel free, to feel happy, to not feel weighed down by what I'm going to eat, what I'm not going to eat, if I'm being bad or good with my food. Not having the guilt is a game changer. Thank you guys so much for watching this. If you think this info is going to be valuable for someone in your life, please don't hesitate to share this video out. Let me know what's worked for you. Maybe there are other tips out there that I haven't even tried yet. And of course, I love it if you like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I put out new videos every Monday, so be sure to subscribe so that you never miss a Monday. Thanks again, guys. Go keep being awesome, and I will see you next week. Sophie would also like you to know that you're awesome, but she's a little preoccupied with being exhausted from being a cat.